man, first round of the night, got super far, and then managed to crash the Switch. This sucks. All right, let's do this. Smoothest I've ever been there. Whatever. Brilliant. I did learn something interesting just now, though. If you manage to mash your way into a pause before the new item thing appears, then using start to dismiss the new item text box, this one right here, which for certain items causes you to auto pause irrespective of how many times you actually hit start. That pause after the menu, or after the text box, doesn't happen, which is neat. Say to the rumors that all of my speedruns are actually TASs because I'm legally considered a tour? I mean, yeah, that's true, I am. Like, that's just the law. A fun couple seconds for us. Huh. Neat. Well, both of those were real silly and real embarrassing, so... 7. Not used to that working out in my favor. I don't know what to do. That's gonna throw me off my game. Have a good night. So I just did that thing that I said I wanted to do. Six minutes down, 1 hour and 50 minutes left to go. This is basically in the bag already. Not happy about that. Oh no. This is not how I want this to go, even a little bit. So we're losing some time here. Bummer. I'm honest to God real upset that I didn't lose time versus my PB in that split. God, the world record sucks. It's so bad. Why am I even allowed to pretend to be good at video games? This is terrible. Some kind of pigrit. I like it. This character is specifically a shout out to the shopkeeper from Wonder Boy 3. He's a pig. An eye patch. He says, shopping please. Really hoping that I get a poison pup here. Cool. So, getting poisoned, if you're not an idiot who's bad at video games like I just was, gives you an inordinate amount of iframes. The best fight ever, but whatever. Oh, Good luck. There we go. Kick Pig Bro. Kick his nicotine habit from the other games. Yeah, unfortunately. That's like the one thing that they got wrong about this character is that he doesn't smoke. I guess since none of the other transformations smoke and your character didn't before being turned into a pig? Oh, that's true. Technically, you are actually a child. So, yeah, smoking would be bad. It's easy to forget that our intrepid adventurer children are actually, like, 12. Thanks for that. Yeah, the crouching pose is amazing. One of my favorite bits of animation in the game. Which says a lot because the game's animation is real good. Vehicle. It's definitely a good enough boss fight for it to be a gold. Sorry, I said anything. Yeah, shouldn't have said that. Still a gold. Holy cow. It's not a small gold either. That was a real good split. Yeah, Che, he smoked as a shopkeeper in the older game. But this is it's a shout out to the shopkeeper, we're not actually the shopkeeper in this game. We're just some kid who was cursed by our drunk uncle. That is actually the plot of the game. I mean, drunk uncle who also has been convinced by the king's counselor who himself has been turned into an evil cat. Well, he was evil, now he's a cat. Still evil. It's going to be a real shock at the end of the game when that character that I just spoke to turns out to be working for the main villain. No, Faizu, I assume that you've always been a cat since, like, the dawn of time. But yes, also evil. Also perfect. That's true. Going from an evil counselor to a non-evil cat would probably be a really difficult thing to make happen. Also, this game's kind of glitchy. So if you like glitchy games, I've got good news for you, friend. Discussing the possibility of murdering Casa Grande contestants 5 minutes ago, and you don't appreciate me insinuating otherwise. Faizu, we've been friends for a long time. Well, we've known each other for a long time. I know better than to presume that I am the friend of someone who is as evil and powerful as yourself. If you were discussing the possibility of Casa Grande murder, do you think that I would be the person to spill those beans? I'm hurt. That's all I have to say. That's right. Giving them Weir back is not technically illegal. No, can't clip through this door. I don't have the dash yet. I need the dash to do the, to Nyx. Oh no! Gonna be real? That didn't save time. Oh my god, I'm the worst. Faizu. Honestly, I feel like anybody who enters Casa Grande who's not gonna veto Weir back, like, that's just failing to do your own due diligence at that point. How in the world did that almost gold? Oh, that's right, I forgot. I haven't had actually a good segment now that I've worked out the one cycle strat. That's why. I mean, sure, Faizu, but again, like, we all stream to We're Back, a Kuso story. That's our... That's a stream group that we're all in. Stream team. Anybody who doesn't take that knowledge and go, okay, but what does that mean? Like, they're just asking to play We're Back. Also, Melis, I do want to point out to you, Vito is telling the game master that you have played a game before, or you know a pretty good portion of its content. And tournaments like this only work if we're being honest. Also, while there are not any Kusa Grande GMs on whose bad side I particularly want to be, I'll warn you against getting on Faizu's bad side. When Faizu uses the nuclear option, select. Also, on the off chance that this does end up world recording, hello friends, let me recommend that you all follow and subscribe to Grossincha and watch the Kusa Grande Bad Video Games Tournament. It's real fun. Nyx, I honest to God do not know why you're not in Kusa Grande. I feel like it is the sort of thing... It's exactly what I wanted. Anyway, I feel like it's the sort of thing that you would really enjoy. And while we do, you know, joke about using our GM powers to you know, bring people pain by way of bad video game, Faizu's picked games for me. They're always, like, real fun. Virtual Highlight is really interesting to me, because I tend to get motion sickness. And Virtual Highlight is a 3D game, third-person perspective. It's choppy enough that even though it seems to give everybody else motion sickness, it doesn't give me motion sickness. So I really enjoyed watching everybody else at GDQ this year suffer through watching Virtual Hydlide, while I was completely fine. Might be too far to the right. I'm really worried about that. Nope, we're good. Yeah, Blah Jedi. Gyre's really, really cool people. Toucan Chan, thank you very much for the host. Were you working on DKC2 or one of the Shantae games? Given that you're hosting me, I'm guessing you were working on Shantae. Ecclesia. Oh, cool. Well, welcome everyone. I'm Tina Hatz. I do speedruns. Mostly of games that Toucan Chan doesn't run, but also of games that Toucan Chan is better than. Oh, Come on. Sure that every single game that you and I both run, you've got better times than I do. Also, for anybody who isn't familiar with this game, this is Wonder Boy and the Cursed Kingdom, which is still relatively new, just about 2 months old. If you're a fan of the Wonder Boy series, this is Monster World 5, which makes it Wonder Boy 7, sort of. It's real fun. So, the problem with Wonder Boy Returns is that it's explicitly a remake of 1, or a reimagining of 1. So, the reason that I would not count it in as a separate entry, getting its own number, is because of the fact that, well... We also didn't give a new number to the Dragon's Trap. That's still Wonder Boy 3. Switch version is what I'm playing on, so... Oops. I'm gonna change to Snake. Melis, have a wonderful evening. Thanks for dropping by. Wrong direction. Thank you. but I eat peanut butter on a hamburger. I mean, I never have, so I don't know if it would be bad. And I've eaten peanut butter and Thai food, so... I can imagine that it would end up tasting pretty good. Like, peanut butter and savory works fine together. So... yeah, probably. I'd try it. I don't know if I'd like it, but I'd try it. So, for the newcomers, this is called a chest warp. I activated that chest, then saved and quit, and then continued the game. So I dropped back to my previous save point. That particular chest warp saves actually a substantial portion of time over the course of the speedrun. Just because I don't have to come back here and waste like 3 minutes. Gibbon, I don't think you're gonna get a lot of disagreement about returns. Although, I will admit, I might be in the minority of people who didn't like the original Wonder Boy game, so I'm probably the least qualified to have an opinion on whether or not Wonder Boy Returns is a good game. Eon, thank you very much for the host. Welcome, everyone. I'm Tina. I play video games poorly, and also bad video games. This is not a bad video game. This is an amazing video game that everybody should play. Thank you for the good luck. Yeah, for me, as a kid, Wonder Boy 1, technically Hudson Soft's Adventure Island, which I was vaguely aware was Wonder Boy just because having watched people play Wonder Boy and playing Adventure Island, that was the entire reason that I didn't ever look into the later games, which it turns out, really good. In fact, it was the Wonder Boy 3 community, a couple of people from it, telling me that I should try the new Wonder Boy, the new Wonder Boy remake, The Dragon's Trap. Because I was a Shantae speedrunner, and the Shantae series was inspired largely by The Dragon's Trap and Monster World 4. That's the only reason that I even gave the Wonder Boy series a second shot. And it turns out, it was a good call. Real good call. Yes, Hudson Soft's Adventure Island is a Famicom port of Wonder Boy. Yeah, I agree with you there, Hawk. Adventure Island commits the cardinal video game sin. It is boring. I've never played Super Adventure Island. I've been told that the later Adventure Island games are actually quite good. And I've never played them, so I have no opinions on them. Super Adventure Island 4 is super cool. You plan to speedrun it. There we go. The game that has Author Blues's seal of approval is for sure a good video game. Well, okay, let me rephrase. Is for sure a video game that's worth playing. Thank you so much for 17 months in a row. Yeah, Nyx, I really have enjoyed the horror that you have wreaked on 3D games. Fine, I won't get the ring then. I'll just wait. Don't even care. Yeah, Blah Jedi. So Nyx is an extremely talented glitch hunter. Among other things, Nyx is responsible for the strats that are used in Bubsy 3D, which is just a delightful romp through unfinished mess. A little bit of time. Losing more time. Yo, Moogle, how's it going? Now it's a run, let's go. Moogle, I had a good run. Get to just a little bit past where I am right now. And then it hard crashed the Switch. So. Now that being said, this run's way better, so. LFG. Likelihood of it crashing. Well, I've only ever hard crashed my Switch 3 times. All 3 of them were playing this game, so. Don't know. We'll find out. I guess my answer is substantially higher than with any other game that I've ever played. There's brand new tech that Nyx has found that I'm... I'm super excited to show off. Extra menuing that I did there actually doesn't matter, because I'm going to be chest warping. So the reason that I purposefully took damage in that last fight is because I do want to sleep there, because it refills my stamina for running. Yeah, off. And I'll tell you right now that every time that I watch you play a game that Nyx has worked on, like, those are some really good streams. So chest warping here sets up a cycle coming up. So now I'm gonna dash. I get here way before this cycle. I would be waiting until now to even get on that if I didn't have that cycle. Things have happened in my life. Not by much. we go. Tea time. I'm out of tea. Water time. So far, none of this is new Nyx tech. This is just an actually halfway decent run, which is kind of nice. Don't worry, though. Nyx tech is coming. Yeah, gotta give it to the devs. They did a really good job of gating progression in this game. So, Nyx says that this works. How? Hold down and do a double transformation. I am. Yeah, I am. I'm doing double transformations right now. Could it be that it doesn't work on Switch? PS4 maybe only. Well, we lost a little bit of time there. Not a big deal. That might be a PS4 specific glitch, which is interesting. I lost, what, probably 30 seconds there? Not a huge deal. We're saving a ton of time because of Nyx strats here, anyway. Law Jedi, have a good one. Thanks for hanging out. One other thing that I wanted to try. So doing that works. And I need to play with it more later. It works in one specific room in the mansion. That's not good. There's a puzzle here I'm supposed to do. But I don't. Thank you. Yeah, it's a good solution to that puzzle. Does anybody know if upgrading the ice sword actually increases damage? I don't think it does. I'm trying to think of any other time that I care about having the ice sword's property of freezing enemies. Alright, so people who don't know this game, this is a Sonic room. At the very end of it, watch and you'll catch a glimpse of Sonic. Unless I die, which I'm working on. Free world record, everyone. There we go. Yo, Hockey, how's it going? Arctic Rivers, thank you very much for blessing us all with that pyramid. I hope you're doing well. We lost one cycle. That sucks. I don't know if this impacts later cycles. Cool. How much time does Peppy Rescue Skip save? A decent amount, actually. Because Peppy moves real slow in the auto not auto-scroller, but, you know, auto-scrollery. Escort mission. That's the words that I was looking for. Escort mission. Alright. I'm guessing that for whatever reason, that one doesn't work. Or alternately, I'm bad. Silverfire, thank you very much for the raid. Welcome everyone. That's weird. Alright, this is the impossible hover. Part one. This part is called, oh no. Yeah. I need the jumps. This is called the stupid hover for those jumps. Second try, that kinda sucks, but whatever, didn't lose too much time. Gotta stay low. Because of those bats above me, doing that. Yeah, so it's the impossible hover if you don't jump through the fireballs. It's the stupid hover if you do. Supposed to have the dragon unlocked by this point? Sure I'm not. This is the boss fight that unlocks the dragon. Yeah, there's an auto-scroller there. It really sucks. I mean, it's kind of cute. And the first time that you go through it, it's, you know, challenging and fun and stuff. It is not fast. Hover is just way, way faster. That fire dragon that you saw at the start of both phases, you're supposed to be riding that, and it moves at a snail's pace, which is, you know, casually a good thing for a speedrun. No thank you. I'm still not convinced that it's actually possible. All right, so there was a lot of bad stuff that I did there, and Nyx's new strats made up for it. But because of how much I just fumbled everything in the volcano, it is unlikely, I think, that we are going to see a sub 2 this run. We'll see. And crash. I was gonna say it was a joke. Please don't. Only crashes on good runs. Yeah, that's true. This run doesn't qualify. This run doesn't get a crash. Given, I want to explicitly recognize and appreciate the fact that you are always here and you are always excited for the Monster Lair portion of this run. Flight, you have a 7-hour one ahead of you with 1 hour of sleep. I'm not a math doctor, but that sounds bad. Playing chicken with a large amount of health. No, Silverfire. Except for the boss fight, there's no way for me to speed that up. Puyo Puyo Pepe. Oh gosh, I would play that game. Menu is boots. Current menu is weapons. So, fans of the earlier Wonder Boy games, please enjoy these stained glass windows. Happy about my health. Happier now. Come on, one more all first options. Let's go. Super hate this.
Okay.
Howdy shoot. Thank you for the good luck. Wait, I don't care about your hearts anymore. Not gonna be a gold, but not gonna be terrible. Not great, but not terrible. You Grim Reaper cat, go away. Let's go. Not great so far, but not terrible. Terrible timing, what the hell? Thank you for spamming my chat with peppies. The more peppies, the happier I'm gonna be. Tell you what, Hockey. Watch what happens next, and then you tell me whether this game is just completely broken or not. Oh dear. This is bad, actually. Let's return to main menu, because I do still need to, get the one thing. Oops. Regardless, you can see what's coming. Yeah, I do still need to get the one thing. I was too excited for it. Still gotta do the race. I mean, the snake phasing through the floor, I would say, is at least a little bit broken, don't you think? Am I off base there? And also, don't worry, I did lose time, but I will still be saving time on this split because of that glitch. And others. I've never completed a run with the current strats that I'm using. This one's not going to be the sub 2, but the sub 2 is going to happen soon. This is bad. Yeah. I'm confused. Me? How's it going? Hollow the Black Mage? Yeah, this game is super, super fun. How did I not pick up the soul? I swear I picked up the soul. I'm so confused. Okay, that time I didn't pick up that soul. Okay, I got the soul. I'm confused. I don't know how that worked. Whatever. Now it's time to fight the final boss. Final boss. Final boss of this area. Okay. Yeah, so it turns out that the snake's hitbox is... used for calculations, but perhaps not in a developer-intended manner. Heppy, would you please eat some ghosts? So, even with me being a complete idiot, yeah, Peppy can eat ghosts in this game. You know, for reasons. $144 golds are nothing to sniff at. Disappointing gold. Gonna be a disappointing world record. It's just the way it is. World record's still a world record. I mean, you're not wrong. Oh god, does... Oh yeah. Oh right, I didn't have to do the bomb puzzle, so I've got like a million bombs. Not the first time I'm gonna be. Mostly because I'm trying to read chat and also do this section without looking. Hasn't every Monster Boy world record disappointed me? I don't know what that has to do with anything. Nice, got it. It's a good animation skip. Also, we're going to be getting a huge gold here as well. Additionally, micro-optimization, I just realized. Like, literally 2 seconds ago, I realized, I bet I could do that faster than I normally do. And the answer is, yes, I can. Jump and slide. Interesting. I was not jumping and sliding. I was holding down and sliding. I'm supposed to be going here. How's it going, Gashode? Yeah, that's new. That is a Nyx special as of last night. Sadly, I was not able to clip through that door. I don't know if that's because it's unclippable or something else. How broken is this game now? It's not unbroken. Personally, I think that this game is the right amount of broken. Like, there's still a lot of gameplay in this. Okay. It could be a little bit more broken. There's a lot of gameplay, and you skip most of the stuff that you skip is tedious. I'm glad that you enjoy watching the impossible hover as a spectator. It's real fun to pull off. It feels super good when you do it. Oops. Nope, no, I would really just... Shut up. It's not even about you. No, this clip's definitely possible in 103. There's only a couple things that we found that aren't possible in earlier versions. And in fact, one of the biggest time saves in this game is 1.0.1 and potentially 1.0.0 on PlayStation only. But a lot of Nyx's testing has been in 103 as well, so there's a ton of stuff that's doable throughout the game's patch range currently. Mushroom King is not possible on 100. Alright, so Mushroom King skip is a Switch exclusive. There might be a skip which is exclusive to PlayStation, we're not sure yet. The wrong side that I blew up. That would have been real bad. What's up? It's me. Yeah, sub 2 hours incoming in the near future for sure. Like, there's not even a question about it. Any new Nyx tricks left? No. Unfortunately. An unfortunate softlock. Yeah. Yeah, so Nyx found a way to completely skip Nabu, which unfortunately puts you in the Dark World, having not lost any of your orbs, but also having not gotten the human orb. Definitely a lot of Yeah, Palom, I actually, I've never played the game with Shion in it. Shion. It is, at this point, the only mainline Wonder Boy slash Monster World game that I haven't played. Author Blues and I are planning on, at some point, doing a blind race of it. Tomorrow I am probably not going to be able to do that. No, I need to kill you. Oh gosh, Palom, you're in for a treat. Monster World 4 is unreservedly one of my favorite video games. And it only gets better the deeper you get into the game. It's just, it's so good. Yes, that did go pretty smooth. Okay then. So check this out, this reduces one minion. This is mostly for the benefit of Author Blues. So I go here. Real bad. But you know. Now I don't have to menu for sword inside this area. This is the only one of these that matters that I have the sword equipped. I'm not gonna get a sub 2. I appreciate your confidence, but I'm not going to get a sub 2. This is going to be a 201. Yeah, there's a lot of just real sloppy time loss in this, purely due to the fact that, like, there's new tech. There's new tech and new strats, and one of them didn't work. You probably can. I'm not convinced that that's worth going for. Not in a run like this. Eventually, that's probably worth it. But today? You're gonna ask that question like 30 more times? You're gonna just copy and paste it now? Yeah, no, that's totally reasonable. No, no! I'm real upset. Doesn't matter. Shot just stupid time loss that one. Come on. Okay. Yeah, of course. Same. Never had that happen before. That's a new one. Neat. Side. of gold to finish it off. Nice. Well, I guess I have to change my title next time that I stream to for sub 2. Because this was a real bad run on many fronts, and got a 2 hour 46-second world record. Off. You need to put this garbage run in the dumpster. I need you to come back to this game and just... I need you to put this game to rest. Make it so that nobody else will ever even think about getting a world record. Until Nips comes up with new strats. Yeah, sub 201, technically. Not even technically, actually. Technically and actually are... they mean different things. Chibi, you're too kind. I'm really glad if people enjoy watching my speedruns. Ariosh, Selethel, Cloudy Shoe, thank you for the GGs. Upthorn, Eon, thank you. Jerzin, thank you. Eric's Omnislush, Alan, thank you for the GG. I think I said Cloudy Shoe, but I'm going to say thank you again. Gibbon, thank you. That's true, the in-game timer is definitely going to say it's a sub 2. This is going to be a 130x, for sure, in-game time. Silverfire, thank you for the GG. Yo, Claris, thank you very much for the GG. Roguelink, we go by RTA for sure. There's too much weird stuff that the in-game timer does, because we use save and quits to trigger the chest warp glitch. Yeah, I mean, that one alone does super wonky stuff to the in-game timer. And then on top of that, there's just a bunch of inconsistencies with the way that the in-game timer tracks things that happen, like if you die. Which, I mean, that would never happen, not in a speedrun. Oh yeah, Auth, I agree. I think that working out the lowest possible in-game time would be super cool. You might not be aware of it. Nick's report has shown... like, he put forward this idea. This one's his. And I think that it's a neat idea if anybody ever decides to run it. I would need to get used to playing this game on PS4 for it to be viable. But the idea is having save files before any chests that you definitely need to get, and having your main save so that it's basically a new game plus mode where you chest warp across gameplay. So... you chest warp for the sword pieces so you can get the sword super early. Chest warp for, you know, shield and everything else that you give a crap about. So you're just always the best you can be. Yeah, you'd have to do all chest warps. And the beginning of the game is still going to be pretty vanilla, but... The deeper you get into the game, the more goofy the game's just gonna get. Yeah, you get the idea. It would be antithetical to what you had in mind. Yeah, so lowest IGT, non-New Game Plus, would be more like, yeah, figuring out how to chest warp optimally without, you know, having pre-built saves. But yeah, I'd like to see somebody do it. I don't think that I want to route that. But it would be a really, really neat run. The town theme in the credits, because I agree with you. You could get at least 2 orbs at the start of the game, Snake and Dragon, because of how their collection is. Interesting. Oh, cool. 138. I think a 130 IGT is going to come pretty soon. Largely by not sucking. But even this one, like, Volcano was super rough. I spent a bunch of time trying to figure out why that glitch wouldn't work. I need to play with this in 101. In fact, I'll do that tonight before I cut stream. I'll play with this in 101 to see if the clip works. Well, if the save file is set up correctly, we might be in, no, in fact, we are in bad shape because my save file was right after a crash after a dragon. So never mind, I'll probably do that tomorrow.